suddenly was with us. We hadn't heard him coming from behind us. We hadn't seen him coming from behind us. And suddenly he was just with us. And he must have been able to see how broken and distraught we were because he walked up to it. He said, what's wrong? What's wrong? I admit I was a little short with him. I didn't want to talk to him. I didn't want to talk to anyone at this time. And I said, what are you, the only stranger in Jerusalem who doesn't know what has happened in these days?
Oh,
This is the peace that I remember as if it were just yesterday. He sat with us at the table with the bread, and he took the bread, and he stood up, and he prayed and blessed the bread. And I don't know if it's how he held the bread. I don't know if it's the prayer that he prayed. I don't know if it's because we could see the wounds in his hands, but something opened our eyes to see that this was no stranger at all, but this was Jesus present in the breaking of the bread. This was Jesus with us in the flesh at that very moment. Jesus was alive, and Jesus was with us.
And we drink of his sacrifice as a sign of our bonds of peace. Around the table of the King,
the love of Jesus is for you. The love of Jesus is for me. He is revealed in the breaking of the bread. He is revealed in the stranger walking with us. Jesus is alive, and Jesus is with us.
Jesus comes to you as a stranger in distress. That's something I read and heard that Mother Teresa said one time, and I've rolled that around in my mind many times. Jesus comes to us in a disguise that is another person who is in some kind of distress. Do you think there's distress in our world today? Any of you feeling stress or distress? It's all over the place, isn't it? And when you see that in the neighbor next to you, there's Christ coming to you, and we so often overlook that or see that. It might even be our kids. My goodness, I have three young kids, and there's a lot of stress around our house with that. Yes, Lord, have mercy.
Hear the sounds of heart.